In my series of 11 life principles, I am narrating my second life principle. I invest continually in my self-transformation. Change. Change means change of form. But the transformation means something totally new blossoms in you. Transformation has to be within us. Self-transformation does not mean you have to amend all your weaknesses. Self-transformation means that you have to excel in one or more of your core strengths. Actually, it requires loving yourself and use positive affirmations about your own self. Let us take an example of a rose plant. A rose plant has many thorns, but what we look at is a rose flower. We accept the thorns willingly because we love the rose flower. This is the key. Plucking all the thorns from a rose plant is an endless process, but blossoming a rose within us is a transformation process. This brings me to a famous story from Hindu Puranas. During Treta Yuga, a man named Ratnakar was living on the bank of Ganga. Ratnakar was a fearless hunter and a cruel thief. One day, Ratnakar was hiding, waiting for his victim. Along came the great sage Narad Muni, who was walking peacefully, chanting the name of Lord Vishnu, Narayan, Narayan. Suddenly, Ratnakar jumped in front of him with an open sword and demanded, "Hand over all you have or else." Narad Muni said, "My child, I have nothing else other than the rags I am wearing. Will they be of any use to you?" Narad Muni's fearlessness surprised Ratnakar. As Ratnakar gazed in the Narad Muni's compassionate eyes, his cruelty vanished. He was rather intrigued. "Who is this strange sadhu?" Narad Muni patiently explained Ratnakar how sinful it is to rob, steal and kill, and that Ratnakar will have to bear the burden of his immoral acts. Ratnakar was sure that since his sins are meant for the well-being of his family, they will share the consequences with him. But when inquired by him, his family members refused to share his sins. They said that earning for the family and feeding them was Ratnakar's duty. How he does it is his choice, and only he himself is accountable for it. Then Ratnakar fell on Narad Muniji's feet and pleaded for salvation. Narad Muniji told him to meditate, focus and chant God's name. Ratnakar was determined to elevate himself over his sins. Such was his devotion that over the years that he meditated, an anthill grew around him. Years later, when Narad Muniji revisited, he found the anthill and heard God chanting coming from within it. Narad Muniji was so impressed that he declared Ratnakar as sage Valmiki, who went on to compose the epic Ramayana and became one of the greatest sages of all time. Such was the self-transformation of an uneducated thief. What we learn from this is, 1. Anyone can transform if one has a will to transform. It is not dependent on your capability, but it is dependent on your will. 2. What you need is a little guidance, but you have to do it yourself. With this, I would like to reiterate that most of the time we know what to do, but the issue is how to do. My seminar, Master My Life and Coaching Courses, has answer to how to achieve self-transformation. But by merely knowing or understanding will not take you to your destination. You need to act. This brings me to my third life principle of the series. I understand that only knowledge with purposeful action is knowledge, on which I will narrate in my next video. Till then, goodbye and enjoy your life to the fullest.
You, me and life. Let us together make this world a better place to live.